Hey, fatty! In this video, I'm going to talk about how bubblegum fucks your ability to burn body fat. Let's begin. So, bubblegum stops fat loss. The main reason why it stops fat loss is because it spikes your insulin. And when you spike your insulin will stay high for God knows how long, depending how fast your metabolism is. It could stay high for 12 hours. And if it's above a certain threshold, you're not going to burn fuck all for body fat, because that if it's above the threshold, it'll deactivate your hormone-sensitive lipase. Insulin's got to be low enough for this hormone-sensitive lipase to be activated. That's number one, hormone-sensitive lipase. Hormone-sensitive lipase, I just say it 5,000 times, so you won't forget what it is. Hormone-sensitive lipase is an enzyme that breaks down body fat. You can go look it up. That's why. Insulin fucks the ability for it to do that. Number two, the gum must be sugar-free. But even this is not optimal because people have psychological issues. And even thinking about food, the sweetness will cause your body to actually have insulin spikes. So anybody that I'm coaching one-on-one doesn't fucking chew bubble gum. I just wipe it right out of the equation. Then it saves me the fucking headache. But here's a story about one time I was coaching a girl, and we lost like a shit pile of weight. She's probably down like 20 pounds. Because even eating the gum, when you fast that hard, even spiking your insulin, you're going to lose weight at the start. But when you get down to that nitty gritty, all of a sudden, we weren't losing any weight. And she was not eating a lot of food. So I knew the math, like the food, she should be cutting weight. I'm like, what the fuck's going on? But luckily, because I always make everyone use ketone piss tests every morning, the ketones were showing up low. And it's like, why the hell are these low when she's fasting like 48 hours and shit? They should be sky high. Because the ketones are low because she's chewing fucking Bubblicious twice a day. And I caught it as soon as we got rid of the gum. She started losing body fat again. Like the next day, her ketone levels were through the roof. And her ketone levels were low for a couple days, but I hadn't spoke to her, so I didn't know. But as soon as I asked her what the ketones are at, they were only like at 0.5 millimoles per liter, when normally they're like at 8 when you fast that hard, or at least 4. So we figured it out. So that was the problem. It was fucking gum. I think there's 10 calories in one piece of double bubble or whatever she was chewing every day at work. So if you want to fucking lose fat, get rid of that sugar out of your trap, even that gum. That's why I keep telling people this. You can eat like 6 jelly beans 6 times a day. Because you're spiking your insulin, you'll get a worse result than if you're actually eating one meal with a true fast and the meal is still small. But if you're eating one meal with a true fast, you'll get a better result than eating 6 fucking jelly beans. And that's exactly how you end up losing muscle mass. Because guess what? When your body can't break down body fat to get the energy, and you're not eating, where do you think it takes the fucking energy from? Da-da-da-da! Fucking breaks your fucking muscle down. That's exactly why eating 6 small meals a day, cutting calories, fucks your metabolism, and is catabolic as fuck and breaks down muscle. And I keep telling people this, and they're finally starting to figure it out, some people. But this is exactly how bikini competitors eat. And that's why they feel like shit on stage and they can't maintain the low body fat percentage. Even a percentage that's somewhat a little bit higher than stage weight. They just blow up like fucking balloons. That's why you see them all the time at the gym and they're all fat on the off season. It's just because of shit like this. You can't eat 6 meals a day if you want to maintain a lean body mass unless you're on fucking steroids or some sort of drugs. So everyone have an awesome day. Keep that fucking Bubblicious out of your trap and get that fat in ya.